Hi, this is Mia. I'm a mess again, and I'm going to send my friend a text and call myself out on my stuff. I am a mess again. Hold on. There's somebody out. I just set a 20-minute timer. Right, so I will show you a couple of pictures. I'm in Portland, Oregon, and I did not pay attention. I asked one of my coworkers at the pizza job. Let me start a picture. I only took three. Oh, this is a horrible picture. I gotta grab tissue. Where's that roll right there? Let me set this 20-minute timer. Oh crap, I already did. Like, I know that I needed to not just sit and mope, and my son wants to show me something. So I like excuse me. I just threw away the lunch. I pulled out lunch meat like 4 days ago, and I was like, okay, it's still good, and now it's like 9 days. I'm like, crap, I don't want to give the kids something that's from that since it was open, or actually 9 or 10 days ago. And some other stuff in the fridge I put in the fridge like, oh, 3 days ago. Crap. The fridge is like 30 degrees. That's it's not frozen. Let me show the pictures. Am I recording? Hold on, somebody's next door now. I just went like last week I was like this and I went. Went to a bunch of meetings. Like, I went Sunday afternoon to a women's meeting because I didn't have to work. I was supposed to go tomorrow. I wish I could go tomorrow because my friend is chairing. I made plans to go tomorrow and I actually might go. I made plans to go and they put something in my schedule. Right, we're gonna go to eBay and we're gonna lower prices on things that are being looked at, watched, or asked about. I'm just gonna lower it either $1 or 10 cents. I have a hard time when there's somebody in the bathroom next to me. I just watched a movie and then I woke up. Hold on. Let's do this one thing at a time. All right, so I have this is some of the items. Most of the stuff is $4.99 to $5, which I do not want. Okay, two watchers on this. I'm gonna put it at $5.90, which is not. $5.90. It's not really that. The last week, I kept my mind and myself busy by going to meetings. I haven't gone to meetings since Tuesday. I don't know. Oh, I've been working really. Like, I don't know why I didn't go. I went Monday. I went Tuesday. I haven't been to anything Wednesday or Friday. I was working Friday all day. Most of the day. All right, so I just go to the next. You might not have anything being watched on eBay, who is it? Hi, I'm back. So my son wanted to play. He was playing Magic, and he hadn't played in a long time. And I was watching him, and I was so ashamed of myself because in when he was in daycare, they had an after-school Magic club, and I wouldn't let him play or watch. And he really, really wanted to play. And he said, "Oh, it would have been too expensive." And I was like, "That's all it is. You're just playing a card game." And I was playing Hearthstone. I just lost again. I have to figure out something. I don't know. Like, I. Feel like, okay, I talked to this lady today who talked about the Jewish in April, I think, more or something, for which word she used, and there this year it's going to be the story of Esther, and I was like, I know the story of Esther. I was teaching her, I was like, isn't that my book that I call the Bible, that you have a different, and I said, oh yeah, that's one of my favorite stories. That I have the movie One Night with a King, which I was like, I should watch that movie. It's like if the Jewish Old Testament of the Christian and the Torah have the same people historically. They are waiting for the Savior to come. So the Christian, I believe it's Christ, and a Jewish person, I don't know. So I was talking to her about some different things, and I had said that I felt a lot of, I was being made to feel like I was going to go to hell if I, I'm gonna change necklaces. If I was going to yoga, acupuncture, Chinese skin, Chinese medicine, like the medicine is just plant herbs. Well, it doesn't have to be vegan, but the ones that I was getting was plant herbs. They have formulas you can add, like animal. There's a one you cannot get your stuff together. I thought I had it. So I felt, I mean, I, they're like, you went. Let me watch Harry Potter anymore, and I couldn't have conversations with people. And I was like, we watched it when the kids were little before we went to that place. And I remember hearing on it's probably Focus on the Family or some kind of 800 AM Christian talk radio. That talked about sometimes you take your whole family, you pay a bunch of money, go to a movie, and something bad is going on in the beginning. You just walk out of the theater, and I was like, they had that it's like not like I don't know if it's like a VCR or like a subscription where it would like you'd like put a movie in and it would. Block out the cuss words or something. I don't know. Like, it's like somebody went through all the movies and like put the time when the sex and the cuss words. Like, I was like, oh my God, I gotta get that thing. My leg hurts. My chiropractor like jammed my hip joint, and I wonder if it's even possible. And that was years ago. I wonder if it's even possible that. To fix that. I'm shooting my hat on the floor. I don't like one. Oh, this should be in the car. I'm gonna go out to the car in a minute. So I was. Having our daycare would have the kids, the old daycare would have movie day, and they would have a list of movies, and they're like, sign the ones you want or sign the ones you don't want your kids to watch, and You had to cross him out, I think. So there's probably a lot of memories. Like, oh, I don't want my kid watching that. And now I'm like, one day they called me on it. They're like, you let your kids like watch The Matrix or like watch some kind of movie. And I can't remember the one. Demolition Man, it's just sci-fi movies. Like, you let your kids watch that, but you won't let them watch Harry Potter. You won't let them watch some Disney movie that has the word witch in it. So, at the church, I was, like, so terrified. But, like, the leaders, they would have, like, one guy had, like, all his DVDs, like, violent movies. And we actually started borrowing movies from him. And he's like, no. He's like, when in Rome, do the Romans, he's like, no. He's like, all these movies have an element of good versus evil. And I was like, oh yeah, like, all the movies and stories are no worse, except, like, if you don't want cussing or sex, they're no worse than the Bible stories themselves are pretty graphic. And the other people would always be going to the movies. And, like, people had a lot of health issues and they weren't getting better, and they're just like, that's the devil, that's just the way, like, don't blame God. And they're like, well, I used to have health issues till I went to massage and acupuncture and used naturopathy. And it was one of the leader's kids who went to see a naturopath and thought, wow, this is really great. It took a lot of times in the church, like, not a lot, where kids would be really nice to me, fair. I have a real, if they met me as a black person when they were little, they could have had an impression of one single black mother. One out of all of the racist programming that media provides. Let's look at the news. Let's see. Flags were half staff. So I had to look that up. Went to library. Flags were half staff because the representative from Michigan, the oldest representative or something, died yesterday. Right, so, let's see, I'm just having one of those days where I'm just like, I was feeling okay earlier, and then I start feeling like, the same way I felt last week. It's like, I text 3 people throughout the day, and since this afternoon, I haven't heard back from anybody, and I'm just like feel like weird. I hate these pictures, they make it look like crazy. So, Royal Pictures. This is just popular culture. Let's go to Flash. I still feel like I have like a foundation where it's you did put the whole thing. You have like God. Have that like for the bottom, I guess, and then you have like sobriety, and like build up my life. Like, I don't know, I'll just make a stairwell, but so if I was building a house, it would be like layers and layers. Oh my god, giant cake. And I feel like I know in my mind that when I use God as a foundation, it's the putting it at the altar, letting God be in charge, and not dwelling on a random Bible verse. And in fact, I am going to. I know this Bible, and I was like, Old Testament, New Testament. I was like trying to think what it's going to be. So I just got a point. Oh, it's upside down. That way it worked anyway. 159 of this Bible, John 12. Some Greeks seek Jesus. Chapter 11, verses 20. John chapter 12, verse 20 through 26. Some Greeks were among those who had gone to Jerusalem to worship during the festival. They went to Philip. He was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and said, "Sir, we want to see Jesus." Philip went and told Andrew, and the two of them went and told Jesus. Jesus answered them, "The hour has now come for the Son of Man to receive great glory. I am telling you the truth, a grain of wheat remains no more than a single grain, unless it is dropped into the ground and dies. If it does die, then it produces many grains. Whoever loves his own life will lose it. Whoever hates his own life in this world will keep it for life eternal. Whoever wants to serve me must follow me, so that my servant will be with me where I am, and my Father will honor anyone who serves me." So, taking it out of context, the whole thing is out of context because I'm only reading a little bit. Number 25, whoever loves his own life will lose it. Whoever hates his own life in this world will keep it for eternal, for life eternal. So, that's a really popular verse. And there's a book down there I forgot about. Alright. When I see, let's say, dating profiles, like, love life, have fun, do what feels good, like, that's the, like, this type of person I am, and I get to where I'm like, I have to think like of that verse. If you love your life here, you're gonna not do well. If you hate your life, you're gonna go have eternal life. You know, and I would say, God, I hate my life. And I would see these Christians like, having these mansions, fancy clothes, and their kids to fancy colleges, and enjoying shopping and eating out all the time, and traveling, and you're like, you seem like they're enjoying their life, like living their life and loving it. But when I was in the churches, it was basically like, kind of like, it's really, you think of, I am a new creature in Christ, and you become obedient to higher power. So it's just like you're living to say the glory of Jesus. Like you're living for as like a servant to that higher power. So your life is yours. Yours to like be taking care of yourself, but not being like 100% selfish. Self-preservation and there's like selfish or narcissistic or abusive. I don't know. It's like, again, I talked about Rachel Hickson's sermon on the treasure chest, or sorry, treasure, what did she call it? Treasure hunt, where she's hunting for people to pray for and talk to and say that God loves them. And having sat down for dinner, and God says, that person right there, and I'm spending 30 minutes crying and praying for this family in a restaurant. It's like that treasure hunt. And there's a lot of measles going on around here. Excuse me. But I don't want to say I hate my life, God, because it's like, dude, shoot, I'm actually turning my phone off. I'm like, I don't want to say I hate my life, God, because it's the enjoying your life, being joyful in the Lord, who sets your life in front of you, and you enjoy it, and you enjoy the ups and downs. And so I don't want to be like, I hate this gift. I'm a brat. I want what I want when I want it. And the truth is, I want to be a brat, and I want what I want. And so I'm struggling with finding joy in everything, or finding joy in just like doing things for God, to be a blessing to others, and I don't take the credit to do what you're supposed to do, and it's the only like energy towards your performance is if you don't do it, then you're being disobedient. So it's really hard for me to like, it's hard for me, it was hard for me to be in the church where people were like hypocritical and everything. But it was hard for me to be like, if I just shut my phone off completely, it's hard for me to, I've been working like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and then Sunday. And I usually work 4 days, one day off, Saturday, one day off, or Friday, Saturday off, and work Sunday through Thursday. And so I'm like, okay, so I just woke up, but it's been like an hour, and it's 10 till, it's 9 till 11 on Saturday night. And last Friday night, I cried like all into the night and made that video. And last Saturday, Friday night, I cried. Saturday, I was crying all day. And oh yeah, I went to a speaker meeting Saturday night. And then Sunday, I had off. I only had 950 steps. I was pretty much in bed all day. I don't know what I was doing. Nothing. I probably was like playing on computers and iPads and movies. Journaling and making movies, and I was sitting around, and I went, took my kid to work, and I went straight to a meeting, and then I went from the meeting to back home. I ended up going to go to bed, try to go to bed early so I could go to Monday morning at 6:30 a.m. And then I went and chaired at my home group at Monday, or my old home group at noon. Oh yeah, then I went to work. So I kept myself super busy. Went to work, and then I went to work at 9 a.m. the next. I was supposed to be working 8:30 a.m. Tuesday. There it was. It's snow day, so I didn't have to be there till like 9:30, 9:40. I was like supposed to be there at like 9:30, but I had to ice. I left, and then I had to de-ice the car. It was my fault. And then, and I was a little bit scared to drive. And I got a bit of fun. And then went to a meeting with somebody Tuesday, and then Wednesday I worked. Did I work weird hours on Wednesday? I think regular nighttime hours Wednesday, Thursday, and then worked morning, Friday, and Saturday. So I might just be, I'm like, no, I've been sleeping at night. I haven't been hanging out with people all night anymore. Like, I shouldn't be so stressed. The local news. So this is the Marion County now. No measles, but two. Oh, no new measles in Clark County. 53 confirmed cases. Oh, I missed the lunar celebration. So yesterday, when there was supposed to be a snowstorm, oops, I got rid of it. It was really, oh, there was like a lot of shootings in the news, on the east side. All right, so I'm studying the cyberpunk. So when my kid got into steampunk, and then I had them watching Mad Max. So I watched Mad Max one time without the kids, and there was a graphic sex scene. I'm gonna look it up. And I went and in the beginning, and I went and borrowed that movie within the last 2 years because I was like, oh shoot, I can't let my kids watch this, and I don't know if I even watched it. And I watched it this time, and that scene was not in it. So let's see, Mad Max 1 sex scene removed. Worst sex scene ever. I'm not gonna play it because it's gonna be I was trying to moving abortion scene, Mad Max, Fury Road. I pretty much could swear that I did not see that scene the last time I watched it. Now, when I watched that movie, I don't know if I could. Sometimes I fall asleep, I watch it a second time. I don't know if I. When I watched, so the first time, I was like, oh God, I can't let the kids watch this. It's really graphic. And then the second, and I remember Mad Max 2, me and my brother would watch it back in the olden days. I thought it was awesome. If anything, my brother was interested in, I wanted to, I thought it was awesome. So Mad Max 2, Tina Turner, I was just like, whatever. And Mel Gibson, that's his name, right? Mel Gibson. And so I watched the whole number one, and it scared the crap out of me. I, wow, it's like fiction, but you're like post-apocalyptic gang of terror. Just, I mean, like you think of, oh, if there's post-apocalyptic, I call it pre-apocalyptic, but if I wait to heaven, and I was like thinking in my mind, like, be without electricity, you don't have clean water, have to, you know, cook your food on fire, like, martial law, curfews, like, but, and think of people trying to get your preps, or the police, and martial law trying to come in, like, they try to, like, exploit their power, and assault you and rob you, or do the power that they are given, and just, you know, this is one of the constitution thingies where, like, imagine you're out in the West Virginia somewhere, and maybe like a colonial war, and the military can come in your house and use your resources, like some of that kind of old timey stuff. Like, well, they have, it's written in our laws that they can come in and just, you know, take your gold, eat up your food, drink your clean water, use up your toilet paper, and, like, so, like, I thought of, like, as a prepper, like, that type of, scenario, and, I was, like, that was just, like, because, like, you think some of the protests and the people starving in the Sahara Desert and, like orphan kids, like, and, like, well, I was just saying with someone yesterday about people not being able to wear a gas mask or a handkerchief being against the law, and then they would attack you and arrest you. And in France, I was like, oh yeah, I forgot, like, my daughter told me, was it my daughter, or just found out, like, it was a month and a half ago, and I was like, oh crap, I totally forgot about that stuff going on. And when I think about cyberpunk, my kids, or my daughter was talking about steampunk a few, like, many years ago, and then steampunk, cyberpunk, and they're like, my daughter's like, I feel like I'm more steampunk, and my son, she's like, yeah, my brother's more like cyberpunk, he's in the computer all the time, and they're like, you're kind of diesel punk, mom. Like, diesel punk? Like, what? And there's, then you look online, there's like a huge list, like, what do you mean I'm diesel punk? And it's like, look on Image Google. I was going to pull it up, but I don't want to copyright. Image Google. Can I do that? Can I do that without any copyright violation? Diesel punk. So it's like steampunk period of time, Victorian steam engine time, gears, metal, leather, and then diesel punk is like big and dirty diesel, and they're like, you're not Mad Max, you're like diesel punk. And cyberpunk, I just finished watching Blade Runner, and I'm like, I don't understand the story. No, I understood it. It was actually pretty simple to understand, which I was like, huh? And yeah, I just remember someone doing that, huh? I should go to the meeting tomorrow. I probably have to go right after work. I'm gonna go if I'm late. So, this is just a Google search. So, I frequently type this into my search engine. Hopefully, I don't get copyright violation. Big metal, heavy, like more gas mask. It's like, look at this stuff, and it looks so scary. Like, military codes. It's kind of like 1940s war technology. Diesel pump fashions. It looks like the 1940s. I had some clothes on my grandma, and jewelry and shoes. That were kind of cool. I mean, these are just images that other people that end up on search engines and stuff. But if I'm looking up cyberpunk, so I'll type in that. And now that that game is out, it's getting really hard. Now that this game, Cyberpunk 2077, is out, it's getting hard to find anything but that. It's definitely just females. It's kind of like, I still think of like Johnny Mnemonic, the underground health, the computer technology, hacker technology, was the spider, the Dr. Spider, and the implants, altering the body, like. And then Spider's Man had all the technology and stuff in there. I kind of think of that as, like, I didn't read Neuromancer. If I did, I read it recently. It's hard. I heard there's a new Blade Runner, so I'm going to check to see if there's that. And then I still need to finish. I'm going to finish this movie so I can take it back. So what I decided to do is study the cyberpunk to keep my mind occupied and then write a novel around it. And my stuff gets spread out because some on my computer, some on my iPod, some in my journals, some on random piece of paper. So I was like, I got an idea. I was like, I'm gonna write a love story of cyberpunk where it's kind of like how the Matrix, like they hack into the system and then they got the agent. It's kind of like this couple meets in this world. And then I decided, you know what, this is really weird, but I have that story, Pico. And where she, towards the end of the story, they're really super domestic. She has twins, and they get into acting. But then there's a catastrophe in the U.S., and they go, like, to their, I think they go to their home in the country and, like, bug in that house, bug out to that house. They bug in, shelter in place, and they had collabed with the neighbors to share resources or whatever. I don't remember. I don't even know if I wrote it down. So I was thinking, that is such a scattered story, and because of the Pika story, she had all their older kids and a set of twins and an older age with her new partner. And I struggled. This is the whole experiment. This 2018 was, I couldn't tell you what it meant to be, to like love somebody or be loved. And I searched media to try to see if I could feel through somebody else, to somebody else's description of like how we met on YouTube videos. And all these movies, well, some of them were like, I have a thing between sci-fi, action, and love stories. So I have Good Witch here, which turned into a love story. 3 Days to Kill. This is season 4, I think. 2018. Good Witch and 3 Days to Kill. This needs to go back to library tomorrow. This was actually cute. It was less gory than I was expecting. It's actually a cute little movie. So I have this book. And I'm sure I had a feng shui. I don't know. I have this book. And I'm going to read from that because I wanted to be a brat. I want, God, why can't I have unconditional love? I feel the love of a higher power, but that's not me with somebody. It's mad. And I said, I don't think I felt love from my parents. I didn't feel like that nurturing happened when I was a kid. It could have, I don't remember. It could have been instinctually. So I said, let's add that Pika story and make it that she doesn't get divorced. She gets pregnant before she gets married. She doesn't get divorced. But something happens to her husband. And it's like MIA. And she meets somebody new. And she doesn't, like, let go because she doesn't sense in her body that he's dead. She doesn't sense that he just abandoned them, and there's no evidence of his existence. Like, no credit card used. He's, like, overseas. No cell phone used. No pings. Nothing was left in, like, the hotel or whatever. No bank accounts being opened up. This necklace is super scratchy. I'm gonna fix it. Oh shoot, that's why it is, all the things are sticking out. I'm looking at my phone and it's like almost 11:15. So I was like, let's add that to the story that she ends up turning cyberpunk world where she meets somebody and they're like the Matrix. When they're inside the Matrix, they're like a certain way, and when they're at home, they're a certain way. And I was gonna make it, because her kids, her little twins became actors and they were getting older, and I was gonna make them the twins. But the twins had money. She didn't want to spend their money. And she goes to strip in Chinatown once a week. It's an old person. And so the twins acting. She doesn't want to spend, they're really charismatic. She doesn't want to spend their money to pay the mortgage because her husband was paying it, but he disappeared. And there's no proof that he dies. It's not like she's going to get life insurance or anything like that. And then, or whatever. And then the twins are in the special school, where they go to school, like, a couple times a week, but then they meet with their groups outside of that a couple times a week, and then they unschool. Like, they have a formal math class, but they unschool, like, maybe math and science, and they teach themselves history, social science, they can learn some things formally that has, like, technical words, like, biology class, or like other little kids, like math class, spelling and stuff. But they unschool and then they meet together with their groups. So say like there's a neighborhood group here and meet at a house or a library. And these were like little kids. And I'm trying to make them maybe 6 or 7 now, because it's like maybe her husband disappears and she's gone. Or I have to work that out. Like, she's alone for a few years, for a couple of years, and then she meets this other guy, and it's really hard for her. It's like she falls for him, and she doesn't know if this is right, or if it's desperation, or if she's just putting him in the place of her partner instead of just like wiping the slate clean and being like, this is a new relationship. So the special school, they come together and teach each other. So instead of sitting in a classroom where one teacher is teaching you the curriculum, say you had 10 kids in a group, each kid will learn his own thing and come together during the small group and go around and teach each other. So then they kind of got, I mean, it's only so much time a day, but they kind of get like a little bit of unschooled, like structured type of day. And so in real life, I reflect my, she's still the night, I reflect my confusion, first of all, it's confusion as to go, reflect my ignorance on, I'll say Saturday, 11:14 p.m. So, feeling love for people and feeling like it's a drug to treat others way better than I've ever been treated distracts me from my own pain, where I don't have to deal with my hurts. So it'd be like, kind of like workaholism. It'd be like you go overboard to please others, so you don't have to take care of yourself. So you don't have to learn how to heal. So I did redo Lisa Aramano's meditation of power. Oh, you are worthy. Or is that what it is? You are worthy. Guided meditation. I repeated that today. I felt like really neutral. There was a part she talked about loving. And I had a weird dream afterwards. I can't tell you what it was about. It had other people in it. So I asked God to help me for a week in my Pica story to find out from studying what love was, because I was getting nowhere with online dating. And having had talked to you guys about my list of kind of little things that kind of weak themes that seemed to be like, that was like how the dice were rolled that week. I did that unconditional love week. And I like this foundation picture. I kept building onto that. Like, you may not like this person, or they may not go out with you. And you said you were going to go out today at 3, and then they totally bail. You still had a foundation of unconditional love for these guys. Yeah, I was sad. Yeah, I was angry. I cried. But things happen. I have a hard time saying this. Things happen the way they should have. And I said, you know, these people, something comes up, these people, God will bring these people back into my life, or will bring us back together. And I feel like I went months still seeking to find out what it means to feel love, or to feel love for somebody. Because you feel like if you weren't loved as a kid, how do you show love if you don't know what it is? If I'm blind, how do I describe sight if I can't see? And I just felt blind. And I went like, felt love for someone, and I got like stomach aches, and like my heart felt like it was gonna dump out. And then I I don't necessarily, like, it could be unconditional love from other people, but I don't feel like I'm getting unconditional love. Like, I don't want to feel like I'm being used to fill time until people find someone better than me. That breaks my heart more than feels like love. But then I realize if you wall off and don't accept love, then it's going to bounce off of me, and the person will, like, the people, like, friends, it's like friends, whether it's friends or a woman that, or friends or men that I like, this love, if I don't accept unconditional love, not seeing that people like me intimately or romantically, if I can't accept it, that I'm not receiving it, and I'm not able to give it back, and that's a foundation before intimate and romance love. You have unconditional love, you have love for, like, your children, your pets, and then you have, like, the close love between two lovers, and I don't know what that feels like, so I'm gonna read a page of this. If it's still the intro, and what I feel like right now is that now this part two of the saga that I'm writing, I only knew in Pika. I don't think that's even the title of the book. Anyways, I only knew this couple got together. They talked like friends. They hung out, cuddled a little bit, had sex. Like, I didn't know the physical touch. Like, of course, I'm a doctor. I did massage classes. Like, I mean, that's what a patient doctor was. Like, you can, like, lovingly touch someone, or lovingly hold hands, or, like, kiss. Hug, like, I didn't know it to write. Like, it's like being a freaking, like, prostitute. It was just like, you met someone, it's a man, it's a woman. The only thing I knew was people have sex. And it's like, there was no, I couldn't express in words what an attached relationship would be, what a committed, attached relationship would be. And like the love, like expressing love for one another, and true romance, Quentin Tarantino's true romance, she was a call girl and they did hook up and then they fell in love right away, and true romance, that kind of happened. Little bit of crazy Quentin Tarantino, like, with my ex, but it was not, like, that movie was real characters, that was pretty pure romance versus my, under the influence, drinking and stuff, kind of, hey, both our moms are sick, let's hang out and chill, so, now, I verbalized my story, like, while I was praying in the car yesterday, and what happened was I ended up, like, oh my god, these two meet each other, the new people, and what does it mean for them to get in a committed relationship? So now I'm stumped on that. Because I had really, really bad relationships. I couldn't tell you one good relationship, but I said I only had, like, less than a handful. Less than, like, five, like, relationships that weren't, like, I know you for a couple hours and now we're going our separate ways, so I can't, and these were basically people I party friendships, and, so, yeah, so I'm stumped. And now I don't know how to write a story. So, it's gonna be like, you met someone, you like someone, you're not a couple. What happens to you become a couple? And what do you talk about? I'll just all write what I just said. So you meet. Oh, I said meet me. You meet. Like each other. Storyline. I was gonna write this whole storyline out while I recorded. And then. Once you be together. The steps. To take. Become committed in a committed relationship. It's really late. I gotta get. I'm gonna probably be up at 7 because that's when the noise starts. I hope, like, so I can just tell you what my ex-husband is pretty much. He came over, spent the night. There was a snowstorm, and then from there, I think he just kept spending the night at my place, and then I was still had been raving with the guys, so kind of like took him a couple times, and it was really sad because he was like, I don't want to hang out with you, I'm gonna go out off on my own, and I was like, oh my god, he's checking out all those raver tricks, no. Hang out with me. I like bought him clothes, I was feeding him, housing him. I don't like, so that's the thing. I don't like being disrespected. Things happen for a reason. I have two great kids. Things happen for a reason. And so, like talking about the love of God or sorry, the obedience. It's like, what is my mission here to leave offspring and die, I guess. It's like, and try to raise someone up the way they should. And it seems, someone was talking, was in a movie about, it was in Blade Runner about the spider getting eaten by the babies. That's a female, single mom, I feel like, and just being eaten alive. Just, alright, you birth us now, you're gonna die. Every ounce of energy out of you, like literally like calories. So I'll set up a plot, background, clothing, the state of the country. Like I could add in like the what the in-laws are saying, you know, taxes I talked about, like, oh, how do you do taxes if you're married? Not filing jointly because somebody's missing, like, I was actually gonna look, this bug bite that I got last week is freaking scary, this is, like, totally, like, freaking me out, and then, so the state of the country, the backdrop, the clothing style, the state of the country, politics, I'll say socioeconomic, just, like, and then the cyberpunk theme is gonna be not necessarily evil, some kind of technology, let's say cyber, some kind of technology, Use for good. Let's say hack. The hacker will say, we need to protect self. I'll say VPN. And so it's like, maybe I could have something where the kids hang out. The little kids had some idea and they're playing around the computer with the VPN or whatever. Maybe cryptocurrency. I don't know what to put. So make up something. And then the older kids help. They're stumped and the older kids help them with something. And it's like in all these sci-fi movies, like the machine. Somebody creates a machine that's like a human, and then the machines want to be in charge of humans, so then they destroy the Earth in the process of trying to say who's gonna, like, you machines were created by us, we're not gonna let you take over. So, trying to think what I, somehow, like, they have a problem, and they're stumped, like, they need one puzzle piece, the older kids help them, and then they're on to something, and but they gotta protect themselves, because if it's like good, someone would try to steal it and market it. If it could be something good, that someone would try to steal it and market it. Let's keep it at that. So let's read one page. Then I'm gonna do I have that pen out of there on my backpack? Looks like my backpack. Let me write down that. So I'll say like. Trends. Discover. I say discover, but more make up. Something. Stumped. I would say missing puzzle piece. And then I put SOP piece, like peace sign. And then older kids help. And then something. Good, so protect from theft or corruption. Dot dot dot. So, in the process of what these kids play with and how they do their alternative school, it's going to be a relationship that turns into a friendship. The lady is, so she'd be different than me in real life, who had an abusive past. She would have had, like, she might have had an abusive past, but with this husband of hers, she had a really good relationship, and it ended abruptly without death. And so she's gonna be kind of like sensitive, like she doesn't like cheat or look at other guys, but now it's kind of like a matter of convenience or just fate or asking God what should happen, and then having this happen, this meeting happen, like a divine connection. And I saw my urban, so I was thinking, like, if you're riding a bike and you want to, in France, and you want to protect yourself from fumes. So you're telling me that I wouldn't be able to wear my Swedish air mask, or urban air pollution mask? Whatever. And, so the character, I guess if it's somewhat about me, I'll go back and write, like, she's going to have to figure out how to keep living her life, because it's breaking her heart that her lover is missing, and she's like trying to jump into another relationship, but she's like before her lover was, when they got together, they were together and they knew it, but now it's like they're not really committed, so she's torn between almost feeling like she's cheating on her husband, that he technically might not be alive, or the fact that this other guy could be dating other women, and she's so busy with her business, her kids, at her home and the stripping job that she wants to just focus on one person, but she's wavering between, like, I don't know. So I'm gonna go eat some almonds and meditate. Looks like I'm still in the preface. Preface. Art of Loving by Eric Fromm. The reading of this book would be a disappointing experience for anyone who expects easy instruction in the art of loving. This book, on the contrary, wants to show that love is not a sentiment which can be easily indulged in by anyone regardless of the level of maturity reached by them. It wants to convince the reader that all his attempts for love are bound to fail unless he tries most actively to develop his total personality so as to achieve a production orientation, that satisfaction in individual love cannot be attained without the capacity to love one's neighbor, without true humility, courage, faith, and discipline. In a culture in which these qualities are rare, the attainment of the capacity to love must remain a rare achievement, or anyone can ask himself how many truly loving persons he has known. Yet the difficulty of the task may not be a reason to abstain from trying to know the difficulties as well as the conditions for its achievement. To avoid unnecessary complications, I have tried to deal with the problem in a language which is non-technical as far as this is possible. For the same reason, I have kept to minimum references to the literature on love. For another problem, I did not find a completely satisfactory solution, that namely of avoiding repetition of ideas expressed in previous books of mine. The reader familiar especially with Escape from Freedom, Man for Himself, and The Sane Inside, will find in this book many ideas expressed in those previous works. However, The Art of Loving is by no means mainly a recapitulation. It presents many ideas beyond the previously expressed ones. And quite naturally, even older ones sometimes gain new perspectives by the fact that they are all centered around one topic. That is The Art of Loving by E.F. I'll read the next quote. He who knows nothing loves nothing. He who can do nothing understands nothing. He who understands nothing is worthless, but he who understands also loves, notices, sees. The more knowledge is inherent in a thing, the greater the love. Anyone who imagines that all fruit ripen at the same time as a strawberry knows nothing about grapes. By Paracelsus. Okay, so then next will be, when I read, will be page one. I still am reading this book. Secret of the Heart now, which I was trying to see if my daughter wanted, and she doesn't have time. She wasn't interested. So I'm still halfway through. I'm going to push pause. Go get some almonds and go meditate only for 5 minutes. And I was gonna go out to the car and check the mail. And then I'm going to come back and tell you how I feel, because I feel. One of my treatment counselors says your life is okay. Like somebody's just. 99 people say something really nice or encouraging. One person says something mean. You dwell on that one negative. And it's like you lose the ability to enjoy life, enjoy, and be positive. So I have a struggle right now where that is still an issue with me. And I dwell on the negative, and then I don't enjoy the positive. And then the positive becomes, like, the law of attraction does not attract positive people. And there's this one lady who just glares at me. I try to ask her a question as a customer in a store, and she says, how would I know? And you see her talk to all their customers, and she's like, oh, yeah, let me help you. I walk by this person, I feel their eyes. Like that. The heck's these people's problem? Like, I didn't do anything to them. So it's like I'll dwell on that person And like someone else was giving me weird eye, and I actually almost paid with the wrong card. Today I was like, oh shoot. And I said, oh, don't go through this cashier's line, self-checkout, because I had a weird interview. And so I had to be like, no, you need to resist, you need to be strong, you need to build up a mental force field and let that stuff bounce off you. And then I get fearful. Someone's like, tell me I was afraid of someone. I was talking to a customer, they were on the phone with two different people, like two different conversations. And I was just like, my mom used to go like this when she was on the phone. She used to beat me. So when she did that, when I talked to her while she was on the phone, I got scared. I got scared I was going to be beaten up because I was talking to somebody while they're on the phone. And B, I think it's pretty rude for somebody to come in to a business to purchase a product that you have to talk to the customer or the counter person and be on the phone. Like, I personally would be like, oh, can you hold on a minute? Like, and I understand I've had important phone calls, like job interviews. You're like, oh my God, they called me. Like, I missed them. They called me while I was in the store. And you don't want to keep playing phone tag. And fortunately, that's happened to me. But I'm going to go get some nuts. I'm sad that the Good Witch, there might be another season. I haven't looked it up. I think she has some movies in the library that I haven't watched yet. So I was kind of getting into that. But it's also kind of good to move on. When the couple, like, were falling in love, it was kind of fun watching those ones. Like, again, it's like a couple of years ago, I'm like, God, I'm ready for a relationship. I just want to wake up and be in the marriage bed with someone. Like, part of the fun is, like, the adventure that of meeting and all this stuff. Even if it doesn't work out, like, that's part of the process. And that's, when it does work out, those are part of the memories. Oh, yeah, I remember when we were in that and this happened. Oh. Hi, that's me. 7 minutes. 7 minutes on the timer. My son was hungry. I didn't want to make food. It's 12:15. Almost 12:15. I was eating while I was meditating. I had an issue. I felt like God was saying love. Not being able to express it, so the words aren't there. Again, a friend said, what are the actions? Or what are the words that are said as keywords? Like, we had, me and my kids had action, like, so militant, like, there's, like, a bad guy around, I'm gonna be like, you know, I have a secret knock. Don't answer the door unless you know the secret knock. Now we do, like, this other saying. You'd be, like, level yellow, yellow, orange, yellow, red, or the color, yellow, red, color, red. I went downstairs and I realized that I had to focus 7 days a week, 7 days of work. Need to see patients on Monday, go back to work Tuesday, Wednesday, to dentist on Thursday, take our kids, kick to the house. Supposed to have a U-Haul truck by Wednesday to haul stuff off to the dump. So, I'm gonna burn this candle for the next 6 minutes. And I'll get my kids food, and I'm gonna email the jump and ask for her to bring some items and a U-Haul truck. Good night. Happy Saturday. Oh, it's like Sunday morning. Happy Saturday, Sunday.